Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to run stable diffusion models locally with the help of ComfyUI. So I'll be showing you the entire setup, how to install ComfyUI in Windows as well as get stable diffusion models running in it. So let's get started. First thing, just Google ComfyUI GitHub. You'll be getting the official link from Comfy Anonymous. Just select it, and here if you just scroll down, we'll be having the Windows installation guide. So as you can see here, I'm having installing Windows Portable, and we'll be having this direct download link. Click here and the download will be getting started. It is about 1.6 GB in size, so just be patient till then. So once the download is complete, you will be getting it as a zip file. You can just unzip it and hope that you are having WinRAR. So right click and you'll be having the extract files. Select it and make sure that you are extracting this particular file in a drive where you have a lot of space. So once you have selected the destination, just click on OK and it will take some time to extract. So this is how the extracted folder will look: ComfyUI Windows Portable, and inside that we'll be having these stuff. So now we are done extracting ComfyUI, and next thing what we need is ComfyUI Manager. So just Google ComfyUI GitHub Manager and you'll be having the first link. Select that, and if you scroll down here also, they will be having the installation steps. So here we will be following the installation method too, and it says we need to have installed Git. And for this, just Google Git download. We will be having the first option. Click it, and we are going to do it for Windows. And select the standalone installer, not the portable one. I will just go with 64-bit. And this setup file is around 67 MB in size. Once it is downloaded, open it. And we'll be getting the Git setup. Next, the default ones are fine. Next, click on next. Just go with the default one and just keep on clicking next. That's it. And the installation will begin. And just click on finish. Okay, now we are done with installing Git. Next thing is we'll be requiring Python also, so it's good to install Python. So just click on Python download, click the first link, and don't install the latest version. I guess it will have some compatibility issues, so I would recommend you go with Python 3.12.8 or Python 3.11. so if you scroll down in their official website, you'll be having this. Select download and scroll down, we'll be having the Windows installer. Click it, and this is small, just 25 MB in size, so it will be downloaded in a flash. And that's done. Open it and make sure that you are checking these things. Okay, make sure that you're checking these two checkboxes at the bottom and click on install now. And just a fast installation process. The setup is successful, so you can just close this and again come back to the ComfyUI manager. So now we'll be linking our ComfyUI manager with normal ComfyUI. So for that, it says we need to download this particular batch file, and it says us not to directly click it. Instead, right click and save it in the folder where we have already extracted our ComfyUI. So you're just going to right click and select save image as. And now you need to go to the folder where you have extracted ComfyUI, and it will be inside this ComfyUI Windows Portable, and just click on save. That's it. And now as you can see here, I'm having the exact same files and folders that they have showed in this particular image. That's good. And now we need to just double click on this particular batch file. This is the final step, so let me just go and double click this, and it will say Windows. Okay, click on more info and select run anyway. So it will install all the necessary libraries and packages, so just be patient till then. Once it is installed, the command prompt will automatically close. And now we can run ComfyUI by two ways. One is by using CPU and another one is by using NVIDIA GPU. So in case if you don't have NVIDIA GPU, you will be selecting the run CPU way. And in case if you are having NVIDIA GPU like me, you need to select run NVIDIA GPU, because if you run with the GPU, it will generate images in a much faster way when compared to CPU. So just double click it as you can see here, we will be getting another command prompt, and here this will display us how many VRAM that we have. I have around 4 GB, which is the 4 GB graphics card, and it displays also my graphics card model. And this will open our ComfyUI automatically in the browser like this, and we'll be having the default interface as this. So now we are done setting up ComfyUI, but we need a model which is coming from Stable Diffusion to get our images generated. So just Google Stability AI Hugging Face and click the first link. So basically they will have these many open source model for video, 3D, code, as well as image. So in case if you want to go with the latest model, which is Stability 3.5, you can go and download this. I am fine with generating images using the SDXL model. So I'll just click on this image and click on this SDXL base model. So it has around 3 million downloads. That's insane. So I'll just click here and go to files and versions. If you want to read how this works, like the research paper and stuff, you can go through it. I will just go with files and versions. And here, if I scroll down, we are having this SDXL base 1.0.0.9 VAE. And we need to just download this. So it's about 6.9 GB in size. Click on download file and just be patient till the download gets completed. So once the SDXL safe tensor has been downloaded, just cut this and go to the exact location where you have extracted ComfyUI. So I'll just go in mine and you'll be having the ComfyUI folder. Open it and go inside models, and here go inside checkpoints and paste the safe tensor file over here. Now after pasting the safe tensor, go to ComfyUI in your browser and just refresh it and reload. And here you'll be having the load checkpoint, right? Just click over here and now you can select the SDXL base safe tensor. Click here, that's it. And now you can just type any prompt over here and the image will be getting generated. So if you want, you can change the width and height also over here. And once you're good, you can just click on this run button. So as you can see here, to the leftmost top, you'll be having this is running. And every time when you run a particular safe tensor or a load checkpoint, it will take quite a some time. So just be patient till then. And this particular green indicator around a particular node means that the process is still in that node. So if a green outline comes over here, it means this particular step is taking place. So just be patient now. So this is the output that I am getting, and it took around 145 seconds, which is 2 minutes and 25 seconds. And the output is getting saved by default in this folder named output. For example, under ComfyUI, you'll be having this output folder, so you'll be having it saved. So this took quite a some time for me since we are running it for the first time. So now let me just go and give another prompt. So I got the second image generated in 48 seconds, and I also ran another prompt, like gave it a forest, and that also took 48 seconds. So since I'm just having a 4 GB graphics card, it's taking me like quite a long duration. And in case if you're having 6 GB or 8 GB or more than that, it will definitely take you very less time to get the output. So that's the video, guys. I hope you'd have found it useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. Learn a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.